Good morning and happy beautiful Saturday in May. It is gorgeous weather out there and I'm still building models and trying to keep up with all the bicycling and the motorcycling and the kayaking and the fishing and all the cool stuff in the summer, but I'm going to still keep building kits every single week to show you. And this one is AMT's 1967 Mercury Comet Cyclone GT. It's got a long name on there, but what it is a cool looking muscle car. It's got the 390 V8 in it. It is a nice looking kit. Let's take a look at all the stuff that will be in the box when you snag yours. This first tree here, excuse me, we've got our dashboard, we've got our radiator support, firewall, we've got our inner fenders, looks like reservoir tanks, windshield washer tanks, we've got our rear leaf springs and differentials. We've got, looks like our front steering on there, shock absorbers, tie rods. Look at the carburetors on that. They're really detailed. Both of them on there. Pedals, steering column are all separate. Got our wheel backs on there. Nice looking first tree to get on the video. Second one, oh, looks like we're going to have separate door panels, which will make detailing much, much easier. A separate console. A separate back seat, front seats, bucket seats on this one, and look at that hood. That is tough. We'll have to get a little black in there to simulate the air intakes on it. Underneath, it's got the nice webbing back there. Good looking piece of plastic. On this tree here, oh, we got some trees tangled together off camera. We got a full exhaust system. Be very easy to paint that right on the trees as it is. And on this one, we've got the parts for the 390. Separate transmission, got our intake, valve covers. Looks like we're even going to have a breather on there. We've got our manifolds, got another transmission, engine block molded as one piece. You can see the valley and everything in there. Got our oil pan, water pumpkin housing, valves. Check out the lines here, linkages for the transmission. And all of our separate starter, power steering, brakes, coil, all that listed on that little tree there. Not a massive amount of parts in the kit, but definitely a lot of detail. Here's our chassis. Got all the holes for the suspension, for the exhaust, fuel tank. Got our front suspension molded in, which will allow us to hopefully build a model that sits level. That doesn't bug me at all. I can easily hand paint that. Got our carpeted texture on the chassis that we'll build our interior onto. So that's always neat. And then we've got that sweet Cyclone Comet body. Now, am I wrong, or is the, I mean, I know Mercury and Ford are our sister companies, but is the Mercury Comet just the renaming of a Fairlane? Are they pretty much the same car and they just rename them like General Motors did with a ton of stuff like the Buicks and the Chevelles and the Pontiacs and all that? Because they look super close to me. So let me know in the comments if they're pretty much the same car. That's a sharp looking body. I like that. Got the windshield wipers molded in. The trim is just prominent enough that we can get our detail on it without having it look cartoonish. Switching to the other side of the desk, we have an outstanding decal sheet with red, white, and black stripes. And I love this. They left the centers open so that we can insert our GT logos in white or silver. So then it'll be the contrasting color. Like that. So instead of printing it with the logo in there and making it all one color, they made it accurate. We've got two types of gauges, dark and light. We've got radios. We've got all the Cyclone logos. We've got all the Mercury logos on there. We've got two sets of Cyclone readouts for the back. We've got numerous license plates. We've got engine. We've even got this cool Champion special event poster. We've got the lights for the front bumper. Really, the refinements on this one, instead of all the extra fancy flames or something, at least I love seeing this. I love when they do all the stuff to make your job a lot easier on the outside and the detailing of the model. We've got a clear parts tree right here. Crystal clear. They've been doing a great job on the clear parts. Separate headlights, which will be great for detailing. Steel axle. transparent taillights, very small transparent red taillights. A dainty chrome tree given the size of the car, but they didn't have a lot of chrome on this vehicle. Got our rear bumper. We'll just need to hand paint inside that where it says Cyclone in black. Got our grill, which is open, so we will be able to get our detail in there with our black wash and all that. Looks like we got our alternator. Got those sweet wheels, a flat coat and some black wash. We'll make those look amazing. We've got T-shifter or floor shifter, or you know, manual shifter. Air cleaner. Not big, but a lot of detail. And then we will wrap up the parts review with the sweet red line tires. Bias ply tread pattern. Black smooth wall on the other side with no brand name on either side, but they do have those nice red stripes. Those are a solidish vinyl. They're not hollow inside, so the wheels will press together after the fact. We've got that in there. Now I'm going to start gluing my Mercury Comet Cyclone GT together, and I'll see you in just a second. Thank you. I think, my opinion, the absolute highlight of this kit will be this 390 V8. This is extremely detailed. This rivals the most modern engines built by Mobius. I mean, this thing is super, super nice. From the carburetor being extremely detailed, and you'll get a better look when I start getting color on things and hand painting. We got that nice distributor with the vacuum. We've got a coil. We've got the oil filler. We got a separate water pump, fuel pump, oil filter. The manifolds are beautifully carved with texture on them that we can hand paint. We got the starter over here. We got the manual transmission, so I use the linkage on it. If you want to use the automatic, they include the T-shifter and the automatic transmission and a shorter drive shaft. Like you saw, there was two drive shafts in the kit. So very beautiful engine, would look good any sort of hot rod, resto mod, anything. So if you need a 390 V8, this kit is your choice to grab one. We've got all the other parts in the kit just kind of set out here, even though much of them don't need any assembly, but that's how I cut the trees apart to get things painted. The belt and pulley system with the fan, the alternator is chrome, that will be attached later. I'll give that alternator a black wash to tone down the chrome tone on it. We got the dashboard, the interior pieces, which will all be painted the same color. We got the exhaust again. And then on this tree, we've got our wheel backs, our drive shaft, our reservoir tank, and our windshield washer tank, which and the rear shocks, which will be sprayed up and then detailed on their own as we go. We got the radiator support. Now, as you watched me build it, I kept putting the radiator support back in place just to make sure that I kept the fenders in these grooves lined up. These help you line up everything perfectly on those inner fenders. I have not attached the radiator because getting the 390 in there, this will get in the way when we drop it under the hood. But this I can, with these gorgeous little grooves molded in, a little drop of super glue into each one of those grooves after it's painted and right on the front there. Got our horns attached, so we're not going to have any problem with that. On the body itself, nothing to do except that I did degrease it. I did wash it in soapy water and get it ready for painting. Not cutting down any model company whatsoever, but it seems within the past like year or so, washing bodies has become much more important than it used to be. It used to be you could get away without doing it. I've noticed that when I don't wash bodies, maybe every 25%, every 1 out of 4, I'm having problems with some fish eyes on the upper surfaces of the kits. I'm not cutting anyone down at all. You're going to run to the message board, oh, Chris, that HBI guy said, and you're going to be talking all stupid. No, I'm just saying it's always been good practice to do it, and possibly the way they're injecting the molds now, the way the plastic is, maybe they're using a little more oil in it and stuff like that, or a little more lubricant in the molds because the molds are older. Maybe that's causing a little bit of that. So I still, and I always have recommended washing your bodies, especially the bodies. Haven't had much, you know, problems with the smaller pieces, the interiors and stuff fisheyeing, but it always seems to be the flat upper surfaces of bodies have been fisheyeing for me. We've got our steering wheel and turn signal indicator. You don't get those turn signal indicators on BMWs because they never use them. We've got our suspension and driveline, which is very, very detailed on this kit, very nice looking. We've got our differential in the back, and I wanted that separate because the exhaust is one piece. I didn't want to cut the exhaust this time and make it fit. Plus, on this one, I have to paint the differential, the gears. I actually have to paint the front all the way around the housing there, with red paint when I get done over the black. So I wanted to get this attached and lined up and then take it off so that I can spray it and then paint this part red in the front like it would be on the real one. You can see underneath where the suspension mounted in, then we've got our kingpins and our steering and our transmission brace. They all just lay in there perfectly. We got our upper suspension arms and our coil spring strut there, and it all joins in and looks lovely. We've got our firewall and our inner fenders. According to the screenshots that I've seen, this is all black. This above this line here is usually the body color, but everything else is all black. So we can just hand paint that with a paint that's close to the body color, and the rest I can get all sprayed together and make my life a billion times easier. So that's it. The kit goes together nicely. You saw me do it on film, and it's not going to have a problem. Please always remember to wash your bodies. When in doubt, scrub your body. And I'm going to hit the paint booth right now. Thank you.
Thank you.
So far, it's been so good on the Comet Cyclone. I really love the look of this car. I think it's got that little bit of a mercury tone to it with the full Moco ideas behind it. That cherry red is one of my absolute favorite colors to paint cars. And for some reason, I pick it for all the Mercuries, Dino Dons, everything. I'm always picking them for those. And it looks lovely on there. The glass fits in easy. You see how well it was to do the chrome trim. We got the little black inserts on the hood there. The grill just presses in place. If you think you have it upside down, it won't fit that way. So you don't have to worry about remembering which way, even with the, you know, the hood ornament and stuff, to get it in there the correct way. So it looks lovely on there. No issues with the fit on that. The front bumper, when we're all done and get the body on, that's going to go right up in there and fit on there. So she's going to be a tough looking ride. The rear bumper just pushed in with friction. I'll take it off before I put the car together and then push it back in when we're all done. But you can see my hand painting, and then just a wipe with a Q-tip across the back exposes the Cyclone on the back. So on that part, I won't have to use the decal. I think that's a tough looking body shell, and the paint job came out quite nice for spray can paints. Then we've got our red on red, because I saw one for sale that was red on red, and I do like that look quite a bit if you can contrast it enough. And that Tamiya dull red is a good looking color. Now, I didn't use the decals for the dashboard on mine. A lot of times I use them. This time I didn't. I just painted across the dash with the chrome there, and then just black washed the inside of those gauges, and they look great as they are. So I left it alone. We got our center console in there, glossed what I wanted to gloss, and then did our door panels and everything, and just made it shine. Dropped at 390 under the hood. You saw me do that. Glued the front end on for the radiator. Connected the radiator line. Put the reservoir in there and the battery. And then underneath, we've got our detail for the chassis. And I made sure, as you saw, to paint that gear a red color. And then we've got our drive shaft lines up. The exhaust all lines up to the manifolds without a fight. And it looks great on there. So we're all set. The tires are just all friction fit. So we may have some fall off before I'm completely done. But all I have to do at this point, with the interior being built on the chassis and the engine in and everything is done, is just get that body on there, attach my front bumper, put on the stripes. I'm definitely going to use white. The black would look cool too, but I'm for sure using the white because I love the box art on this model. And then we'll get our logos in there, get some license plates, get our Mercury logos and our Cyclone logos and our hood ornament and whatnot. We'll get all that done, and I'll give it two coats of Future Floor Polish or Quick Shine, whatever you prefer, and I will come back with that final. Well, how about this, folks? The big, beautiful 1967 Mercury Comet Cyclone GT is done. I did a red on red. Look at the shine on that bright red Krylon paint. It looks awesome. I used the white stripes. Now, you could have used black, a little more subdued, but come on, bright red with the white stripes with the GT emblems. Now, the GT emblems I used on mine instead of the silver. I used the black because you can see the red through it. So it's very, very subtle. You can see it just going through there. I like the look of it with the red stripe tires. We got the big 390. I use the Cyclone logo on the hood. You don't have to, but it is there as an option. Put the Mercury logo on the back. Then we hand painted the back for the Cyclone logo. It looks awesome. It fits the part. It looks tough. It looks mean. I would cruise this. I've always liked the off-brand muscle cars. Now, we know Mercury isn't a small brand, but what I mean by off-brand is it's not its parent Ford that owns it. Just like I always think the Buicks, the Pontiacs, they look just enough different and unique that it's not your run-of-the-mill Chevy Chevelle. You know, you got a Buick GSX, you got a Pontiac GTO, you got the little differences that make it, and that's why I think these Mercury Cyclones are pretty tough looking cars. And this kit is an excellent example. The glass goes in nicely. You got the option of putting in the rear glass, which is great for the detail guys. We've got the beautiful white letter tires. Those wheels are every bit stock perfect. The grill fits in nice. We got the clear headlights over the chrome grill. That interior goes together with no fuss, no muss. They include all the factory badging you could want for the car in multiple colors. So if you do it in black, you can use a red or a white stripe or do whatever you want. There's all kinds of options on that sheet. And the hood is molded in beautifully. It's molded in so nice that I could get the black in there to show that they should be open for air intakes, and did that darker red interior to kind of accent how cool that bright red exterior is. Thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over. I'm not sure if this is available on the market by the time this video comes out, so I will link in the description where you can either order it or get it on pre-order, and so you can get a hold of it. Now, the decals went on without a fight. Even the little Mercury logo on the back looks good. We've got the Cyclone logos on the front fenders, and the body stripes, as you can see on the box, they go over the fenders on either side. So that's what I made sure to do with mine, is loop it all the way front to back, use some decal solvent, and then it just sucks around the inside of those fenders and looks great. All the glass fits in, all the taillights, the bumpers, the rear bumper, and the grille are friction fit. The front bumper is held on with super glue. No problems at all with assembly, final assemblies. The dashboard went together nicely and was detailed all with paint on this one like you saw. I enjoyed the kit. I'm glad they sent it over, and I'm glad I built it, because I think it is a mean-looking machine. As always, when you get your Mercury Comet Cyclone GT, you better build that thing for you and no one else, unless you're being paid to build it for someone else or doing it for someone else, but enjoy your models your way and have fun doing it. It's a hobby. That's what we're here for. We're here to have a great time. Let the haters be your motivators, and we'll see you at the next review. Thank you.